Welcome to Microwave Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain circular waveguide. So to explain circular waveguide, in this session, first I'll be explaining basics of circular waveguide. Then I'll explain structure of circular waveguide. Then after, I'll explain designing of circular waveguide. And then I'll sum up this session by explaining applications of circular waveguide. So let us begin this session with first point, that is basics of circular waveguide. So when we talk about circular waveguide, it is easier to have a manufacturing of circular waveguide compared to rectangular waveguide. So manufacturing is easy of circular waveguide compared to rectangular waveguide. When it comes to joining of two waveguides, it is easier to join circular waveguide compared to rectangular waveguide. So joining of two waveguide is easy in circular waveguide compared to rectangular waveguide. But problem is it occupies more space compared to rectangular waveguide. So we don't use circular waveguide in most of the every applications. Yes, obviously we can use it to have easier manufacturing and easier joining, but it requires more space. So when space is the concern, at that time we don't use circular waveguide. Dominant mode of circular waveguide is TE11. So this is very important point, one should remember this. Dominant mode of circular waveguide, that is TE11. But because of so many frequencies are interfering to dominant mode, it has more interference at dominant mode compared to rectangular waveguide. So it has more interference at dominant mode. Now let us see some more basics so it will be more clear. TE01 and TM01 modes are rotationally symmetrical. So due to these two modes are rotationally symmetrical, rotation of polarization can be overcome. So ultimately, when we talk about circular waveguide, it has problem regarding rotation of polarization. But due to TE01 and TM01 modes, these two modes are rotationally symmetrical. So we don't have that problem of polarization rotation with these two modes. But all modes are not rotationally symmetrical. So this problem will be there with other modes. Now, when we talk about circular waveguide, it has few advantages even, like TM01 mode that has lowest attenuation. So TM01 mode that has lowest attenuation. So basically, it is suitable for long wave transmission, long waveguide transmission. So basically, TM01 mode has lowest attenuation in waveguide category. So we can have long distance waveguide transmission by TM01 mode using circular waveguide. So let us review again. First of all, it is easier to manufacture. Joining is easy, but it occupies more space. So this is what regarding construction. So one should be clear, like manufacturing is easy, joining is easy, but it occupies more space. Dominant mode of circular waveguide, that is TE11 mode, and at that mode interference is more. Now when we talk about TE01 and TM01 modes, that is rotationally symmetrical. So rotation of polarization can be overcome, but that rotation of polarization will happen with other modes in circular waveguide. And one more important point that is there with circular waveguide, that is TM01 mode has lowest attenuation, so it is suitable for long waveguide transmission. Now let us move on to next point of this session, that is structure of circular waveguide. So as we can see, I have aligned circular waveguide with respect to Z direction and its radius is A. So propagation direction is in z direction. And one thing that is even common with rectangular waveguide, that is TEM mode is not possible over here. So TEM mode is not possible in this rectangular waveguide. So only TE and TM mode is possible. So we'll be providing TE and TM modes only to circular waveguide. So it is having radius A. Orientation I have considered in Z direction. Now see, I'll not go in derivation of circular waveguide equations, but directly I'll be mentioning those equations which is required to design circular waveguide. So let us have next session, that is designing parameter of circular waveguide. So when we talk about designing of circular waveguide, cutoff frequency, that is XNP divided by twice A square root of mu epsilon, where this is what based on Bessel's formula. So XNP that we can calculate based on XNP, that is based on Bessel's equation. So that is very different equation, Bessel's equation. Right now I will not discuss about that. It will be given to you in terms of problems when you calculate it, or you can take a table of Bessel's equation where everything will be given to you. So right now you just consider it is what XNP, that is based on Bessel's equation, and that divided by twice pi A square root of mu epsilon. Now here even this should be clear, like velocity, that is 1 divided by square root of mu epsilon. So we can say frequency fc, that is XNP velocity divided by twice pi A. Even that could be said, the reason is velocity is 1 by square root of mu epsilon. Now based on that we can calculate cutoff wavelength, that is velocity divided by frequency, cutoff frequency for cutoff wavelength. So that will be 2 pi A divided by XNP. And for TE11 mode, this value of XNP based on Bessel's equation, that is 1.841. So that will result into cutoff wavelength, that is 2 pi A. Now phase velocity, so that is velocity divided by square root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, where f is operating wavelength and fc is cutoff frequency, f is operating frequency and fc is cutoff frequency. Guided wavelength, that is lambda g is equals to lambda divided by square root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. And wave impedance, that we can calculate as per Z wave impedance, that is equals to eta into square root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, where eta is 120 pi for free space. So we can have wave impedance by this basic formula. So we should note down this formula for designing fc, cutoff frequency, that is XNP divided by 2 pi A square root of mu epsilon, where we can directly say even velocity is 1 by square root of mu epsilon, where mu is mu 0 mu r, epsilon is epsilon 0 epsilon r. And based on this we can say cutoff wavelength, that is velocity by cutoff frequency, and that you can say that will be 2 pi A by XNP as per this. For TE11 mode, XNP value is 1.841, and phase velocity, that is velocity divided by square root of fc, 1 minus fc by f whole square, and guided wavelength is lambda g is lambda by square root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. And wave impedance, that is eta into 1 minus square root of fc by f whole square, where eta is 120 pi for free space. Now let us sum up this session with few applications. So as we have discussed basics of circular waveguide, there are few applications, like we can connect that circular waveguide to feed reflector antenna to the horn antenna. So we can connect this circular waveguide to the horn antenna and that horn antenna could be utilized as a feed of reflector antenna. It could be utilized for short and medium distance broadband communication. So this is what very important application for short and medium distance broadband communication. We can use circular waveguide. And as I have discussed, TE01 mode for circular waveguide, it could be used for long distance waveguide transmission about 10 gigahertz. So that is even very important application. Thank you so much for watching this video. Here you can see complete microwave engineering playlist, and even I am making few more subjects regarding electronics and communication. So you will be finding so many subjects in my channel. You just go through it. Thank you so much for watching this video.